down, Pete, will you?
Get me a shirt on, Slats. I'll be right back.
Hello, Riley.
Is my wife gone on yet?
No, you've got plenty of time. I hope you win your fight tonight. I got a fiver on you.
Yeah? Uh-huh. Well, when the fight's over, you'll have a tenner. And I'll be the new champion.
Oh.
All right. Thanks. Hi, ma'am.
So you remember my name? Say, where you been all this last week?
Now, listen, honey. I didn't come up here to argue with you, but I couldn't fight for a championship tonight without a good luck kiss from you. Come on, come on. Ain't you gonna make up? Oh, come on, man. Give us a little kiss, huh?
Oh, sure. I'll kiss you for luck. It's more than you deserve.
I know it, ma'am. You're swell. And just as soon as I win a title, I'm going to come rushing right back to your arms.
Yeah, I've heard that one before.
Oh, no, but this time I mean it. On my word as a gentleman.
Well, if you don't, it'll be the last time I'll wait for you.
I won't keep you waiting, ma'am.
And no blondes.
No blondes.
If there's any celebrating to be done, we'll do it together.
That's a bargain. And now I got to run along. But not before I kiss little Joey goodnight.
Oh, no, don't wake him up.
Well, I ain't seen a kid in a week. He's got to wish me luck, too, ain't he? Hi there, Joey. How's the little champ?
Look at him, Mom. Ain't he a corker?
Leave him alone, Pete. Don't get him excited.
Show me how you give him a corkscrew, huh? Huh? Oh, that's a boy. Did you see that?
He's a real palooka.
Give me a kiss. Well, too bad you can't be at the ringside to see the old massacre.
Yeah? Now, be sure you use that corkscrew in the ring. And not to pull corks with.
Oh, sure, sure.
Pete!
Yeah?
Good luck.
Thanks, ma'am.
Out, huh?
Yeah, come on, Jim, show us. Come on, right, old boy.
Well, I tell you, it's just how it was, see? It all happened in a twinkling of an eye. I catches him coming in, see? And I nails him with the old reliable, just like this. Oh, Jim, wait, did I hurt you?
Oh, no, do it again, I love
you. Oh, congratulations, Mr. Jim.
What can I do for you?
I'm looking for my husband.
Just like...
Yeah? Tell that to the Marines.
She's at the cops. Hello, ma'am. How are you?
Nice of you to be so interested. Look here, Pete. You're on the wrong road, and you're walking fast.
That ain't no way to talk to me, ma'am. I'm the champ.
You're the champ, Paul. The champ sucker of Broadway. Too bad you didn't get a beating tonight. You won the fight, but you've lost Joey and me. And there's one other thing that I forgot.
Oh! She hit me.
Oh. He's not the only one in the family who carries a wallop.
She's mad at me.
I'm in Variety this week, Crystal, in the has-been column.
I sort of feels like a has-been myself.
Oh, go! Oh.
Huh? What is it, Mom?
On your way back from the station, I want you to stop and get me a spool of black thread, number 60.
Drive me up, honey. There's a customer. Drive me up to the van.
Up on. Here we go.
Lightning? Pleased to meet you, stranger.
Are you hurt?
Are you going to give me that money?
Ingrate. Throwing me, your manager, out of my own car.
Are you going to give me that money?
I'm giving you a slight curl of my lip. That contempt that's browsing over my features, Dynamite. Nothing but contempt.
It's contempt, is it?
Yeah.
Hey.
What's brawn against brains? Mentally, I got you licked, Dynamite.
Oh, yeah?
No, wait. You can't do that.
I can't do what?
That.
How would you like a good punch in the nose?
Oh, I wouldn't like that at all.
No?
Pinch me. I've got hallucinations.
I'm sorry, but you made me do it.
He's apologizing for his own strength. Never mind him.
Say,
an idea is bursting through my brain like a bombshell. First, let me introduce myself. I'm Nobby Walsh. I manage fighters.
Prize fighters?
Right. You just knocked out my best fighter, and that makes me your manager, if you believe in signs.
You mean you think I can be a fighter?
Think? After seeing that right hook of yours knock out Dynamite Wilson?
Dynamite Wilson?
I can make a great leather pusher out of you. I'm telling you, it's in the cards. Meeting me here is no coincidence. It's destiny at the crossroads. What's your name?
Joe.
It's thievery. It's confiscation. That's what it is.
I'll get them for you.
Oh, I'll let him have it. I only made one payment. The finance company will get it anyway.
Yeah.
As I was saying, ain't you listening, Joe?
I've got to get these eggs on the train.
Eggs? With a right-hand punch like you got? Sign this contract and you won't never have to look a neg in the face again.
I wish I could, but I can't.
Now listen to me. You can't turn this down. I'm telling you something that's a chance. Why, it's heart-rendering to see a guy like you wasting his talent with pigs and chickens.
You're right. I'd sign in a minute, but I got my reasons not to.
Well, what are they?
Well, they're my reasons.
It ain't healthy living in the country. Why, look at me, raised on gasoline fumes and carbon monoxide, the picture of vigorous vitality.
I've always wanted to be a fighter, but...
Well, why can't you be?
My month anything to do with fighting, on account of, well, you see, my dad was Pete Palooka.
Did you say Palooka? The grand old champ?
Yeah, and he was great in his day.
Boy, the fortune is smacking us on the head with a champagne bottle. We're launched.
Hitting that bag.
Oh, don't you feel well?
Oh, I feel fine. And opportunity has knocked at my door. I'm going to be a leather pusher.
What?
Sure. I'm going to breathe carbon monoxide and gasoline fumes instead of fresh air.
What are you talking about?
I'm going to the city to be a fighter. I can see my name in lights right now. Joe Palooka, the champion of the world. Just like my dad.
You mean you're going to be a prize fighter?
Sure, and I know I'm doing right. You know things are bad here on the farm. The only thing that worries me is I can't tell Mom.
Oh, you've got to tell her you're going away, Joe.
Oh, of course, I don't mean that. I mean I can't tell her I'm going to be a fighter. You know how she feels about that. But I'll tell her after I've made good. And boy, won't she be proud of me.
And I will too, Joe.
Sure you will. But you got to promise me you won't tell Mom anything about it.
I promise.
And you wish me luck, won't you?
Oh, with all my heart, Joey.
Joe, time for supper, dear. Come in.
Remember. Oh, come on, Mom. Please say you'll let me go.
What is the business this Mr. Walsh is in?
He's in the leather business.
What do you know about the leather business?
Well, I'm strong. And Mr. Walsh says he can teach me to... Oh, Mom, you've got to let me go.
All right, Joe. If you've made up your mind, I don't suppose there's anything I can say or do that'll stop you.
Oh, thanks, Mom. Gee, that's fine.
Oh, I knew this time would come, and I prepared myself for it. But now that it is here, you don't know how I dread the thought of your leaving.
Oh, you mustn't feel that way. I'm not a baby anymore.
You are to me, son. You don't know how I shall miss you.
promise you to.
Will you, Joe?
Oh, but I'll make good, and then I can get you everything you deserve.
Just be a good boy, Joe. That's all I want.
Mom! What happened?
I lost.
You've been peeking. Why didn't you fight like I told you?
I did. But after we got started, he whispered to me and told me to take it easy on account of his wife and kids, and then I don't remember anymore.
I might have known you'd fall for that old gag. Here's five. That makes me generosity itself. Here's five more, just to ease my conscience. Stick them under the shower, give them a rub, and turn them loose. So long, kid. I'm not sore. Every Napoleon has his Waterloo.
Mr. Waltz seems to be disappointed in me.
No, he's just mad at the other fella. Well, kid, better luck next time.
Who was that gentleman?
That's Mr. Levine.
Levine?
Yes, the man who knocked you out.
Oh, I thought his face looked familiar.
I just saw your boy fight.
Go ahead, step on the corn to my wounded spirit.
No, the boy's got a lot of color.
Yeah, he's got so much color that I'm seeing red.
No, no, I mean he tries and he ain't dangerous.
Rub it in.
Right now, the boy's on his way back to the farm. I thought I might be able to use him.
What for? Pitching hay?
No, with McSwan.
You mean to fight the champ?
Sure. I got McSwan on a barnstorming tour. The commissioner insists on a championship fight. And I gotta have a safe setup.
Continue. Your words interest me.
And you know.
Goodbye, Whitey.
Goodbye, Joe.
Thanks for everything.
That's all right, Joe. Joe, where you going, pal?
I don't know. I hate to go back home.
You ain't going back home. I just signed you up for another fight.
Huh?
You'll be a sensation. Guess who you're gonna fight? Guess who?
Who?
The champion, Al McSwat.
Well, does he want to fight me?
Why, sure.
Well, but, Nobby, do you think I'm good enough?
A doubt raiser, huh? Maybe I forgot to tell you a couple of things I know about fighting. Say, leave it to me. I'll make you the Einstein of the squared circle. But remember this. McSwat ain't got no wife and no children either. Atta boy.
You're gonna fight him? You really gonna fight him?
Now you listen to me, Nina. I know McSwat's there.
Shh. Oh, he says that he got a fight for you.
Shall I take it?
Sure, we can use the money.
Sure, you need another bracelet anyway.
Oh, you sweet baby.
I'll take that fight. What? Yeah, yeah. Have I what? Sure, I'll be ready to meet any Palooka on the 29th. Sure, I've been doing plenty of road work.
Hey, Doc! We found some roads you never heard of. My baby's in swell shape.
I can say the same for Nina.
All right, good night.
Good night, Doc.
Good night, so long, so long.
Well, baby, it looks like as though I gotta start training.
Well, come on, let's go.
Let's start.
Ready?
Ready.
Hollywood. Oh, boy, it's some fun. All right.
Hello, Mrs. Palooka.
Hello, Ann, dear.
I heard from Joe today.
So did I.
He says he's doing fine working for that fella, Walsh.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is WXA broadcasting the news events of the day. In the sporting world, fight fans are looking forward with great interest to the championship bout tonight between Al McSwat and Joe Palooka, the challenger. Joe Palooka is the son of the grand old champ Pete Palooka, since retired, who will long be remembered affectionately by the fans for his famous corkscrew punch. In Narragansett...
Ann, did you know about this?
Oh, Mrs. Palooka, Joe didn't mean to deceive you, but he didn't want you to know that he was a fighter until he made good.
Well, if Joe wants to be a fighter, I won't be able to stop him. He's got his father's blood in him.
But if I had that Joe here tonight, I'd show him who's the fighter in this family.
You mustn't say that. Joe's a good boy.
Of course he is, and so is his father. A finer, more upstanding guy never lived than Pete Palooka. Well, I mean, until success changed him.
But it won't change Joe. I know it won't.
No, is that so? You don't know these Palookas. I married one. The only thing to save Joe tonight would be if he loses.
Don't say that.
No. Give me Western Union.
That's a funny way of wishing a fella luck.
Maybe it's just a typographical error.
Well, I'll show her. I'll show everybody.
Oh, gee, hey. I nearly hit you. Wait a minute. Save some of that pep for the fight. You'll need it.
Here he comes now, Doc.
Hello, Doc. Well, here, I'm back to the camp.
Thanks. Thanks to you for showing up for your own fight.
What fight? Meeting that setup will be like shadow boxing.
Come on, baby. You must take a shower. Come on.
And you all take right. The air.
Okay, groin pain.
See if you can sober him up.
He's in pretty bad shape, Doc.
Maybe I ought to call the fight off.
That ain't a bad idea.
That settles it. The fight's off.
You can't do that. The house is full.
So are you.
If I ain't, I've been cheated.
Who is it?
It's me, Nobby.
The fight's off. What? Look at him.
Hiya, Nobby.
Don't talk like that, Doc. Can you afford to lose that money? We're only getting 500, and we'll have to use that for doctor bills.
Miss Swartz, no condition to fight.
He's in no condition to fight. Say, you should see Palooka. He's so scared he's fainted. Why, I'm afraid we'll have to carry him into the rink.
And out, too.
Certainly. But, Mac, you let him stay a couple of rounds, won't
sure,
you?
Sure, Nobby, sure.
That a boy. Say, you've seen my boy fight. He couldn't hit McSweat with a handful of rice. Come on, be a good guy. Don't call off the fight. Let me make that 500.
Go ahead, Doc. I'll knock him off.
All right. Take him to the shower.
Attaboy, Doc.
But remember, don't you try to double-cross me.
Why, Doc, I'm astounded. Your words cut me like a knife. You know my reputation for this integrity.
Yeah. That's what worries me.
It's a lie.
Like that, huh?
That's it, right down there.
Sure. Am I a general? Am I a mastermind?
What happened?
Don't ask no questions. You're as good as champion right now.
Yeah? Is there anything else you want to tell me before a fight?
No. Only remember this guy ain't got no wife and kids.
Oh, he isn't married at all.
Right.
Everything is set for the big battle. However, if my dope is correct, this fight's going to be just one of those things.
Oh, yeah? Well, Mr. Joe ain't no slouch. His paw wasn't
either. Both fighters and managers gathered around the referee.
Fighting. Good luck to both of you.
Pleased to meet you, Mr. McSwat.
First round. Don't forget, we
gotta
go places.
Okay, honey.
All right,
dear. Forget that, baby. Sit down.
You bowl him over as soon as you can.
I'll carry him along for a couple of rounds.
Carry him nothing. Knock him out right away.
All right, Doc. Look at that sucker, will you?
Just look him right in the eye. Just look him right in the eye.
Here.
It's half the battle.
Here.
Go ahead, take it.
Now remember, protect your stomach.
Sure, sure.
I know you're full of booze.
I swallowed it.
Oh. That was the bell for the first round. Again, McSwat rips a lip to the body.
You oh, I'll right die if he doesn't win.
I'll die if he does. I can't listen to him anymore.
Stop, Joe. Give it up. Or do call it dynamite. Oh. Never touch this, Joe.
Now, Joe, walk in closer.
Across
Johnson, Mr. Palooka is very wobbly, backing back on his heels. You had better start heating the coffee, you see. And again, Mr. McSwat rushes in.
Protect his stomach.
In the person of Joe Palooka. Fans must all remember the famous Pete Palooka, the new champ's father.
You said it, another Palooka champion. Sell you, but my son wouldn't fight. Huh? Come on with that, sell you, guys. There you are. I'm going to buy a drink for everybody now. Hey!
Please, Mr. Palooka, will you say something to your public?
It's a pleasure. Palooka will be a fighting champ. He'll meet all comers. You are now listening to the voice of Nubby Wallace, the champion's manager. I attribute his success to my strenuous discipline. Palooka will meet all comers in physical combat as frequently permits. And if frequently don't show up soon enough, we'll go looking for him.
Please, I want Mr. Palooka to say something to the listeners.
I rest my case.
Please.
How are you, boy?
Mr. Palooka.
Well, I hardly know what to say, except I hope you all enjoyed the fight as much as I did. And if my ma's listening in, and I hope she is, well, I just want her to understand that I'm following in the footsteps of my dad.
Well, if you do, I'll break your neck.
I'd like to say hello to somebody else back home. Hello, Ann.
Hello, Joe.
Thanks.
Oh, and Ma, it's kind of cold here in the city. Will you look in the bureau and see if I've got an extra pair of those long woolen underdrawers? Goodbye, Mom.
Come on, champ.
Come on, make room for me.
Hello, champ. Oh, you were wonderful. You were marvelous. I congratulate you. I wish you'd do me the honor to be my guest tonight at the Paradise Club. You see, I work there. I wish you'd come over and see me. Won't you please?
Nobby.
Oh, please do. I will make you very happy.
Nobby.
Oh, please do come.
Nobby.
Oh, you're such a sweet boy.
Gosh, you sing good.
I sing good tonight because my heart is full of happiness. Oh, I had it especially made for you.
Oh, gosh, thanks.
Will you give me the honor of being the first one to dance with the new champion?
Sure. It's all right.
Get that, Doc. He steals my title, and now he's got my girl.
Sit down. Don't be a chump. Sit down.
You can call me Tider. I like it. I love it.
The beginning of the end. That dame will change my gold miner to a nickel's worth of pennies.
Oh, don't let it worry you, Nobby.
Gosh, it's getting kind of hot in here, isn't it?
Well, would you like to go outside and have a little bit of fresh air?
Ain't a bad idea.
All right, we can do it.
Hey, Walsh. Sit down, fellas. The check will be here in a minute.
Listen, you mug, I'm entitled to return match and I'm going to get it.
If you do, I hope I paint over your dead body.
Well, if I don't, I'll knock over that chump of yours right here.
Luca won that title on a fluke. He's no more imp than you're an Indian.
I am an Indian, and my name is Sitting Pretty.
Yes, and if I don't get a rematch, you'll be laying pretty.
White man can now go scrammy.
wall, sir.
Boy, lift a couple of telegrams.
For me?
No, for the Times.
I might as well be non-existent.
Another day.
You telling me? I just unloaded one.
That's different. Where's the champ?
He just left the joint with that Madeira dame.
What? That dame will ruin that kid.
Where's my hat?
Girly, my hat.
What are you getting excited about? He can't fight anyhow.
No, but he can punch. And as soon as he learns how to box, he'll be okay.
Maybe you're right.
Whitey, I gotta save him from that dame. She's poison to champs.
How are you gonna do it?
I'll go on a make for her myself. I'll go to work on her with my suave personality. And I'll sweep her off her feet with my long eyelashes. I'll be terrific. I'll be a typhoon. Whitey, do me a favor. Call me up at Nina's apartment. Thank you.
What'll I talk about?
Talk about a minute. That'll be enough.
Is there anything else I can do for you?
You've been so awfully nice to me.
I could be nicer.
Well, if it's not asking too much.
Yes.
I would like a cheese sandwich.
A cheese sandwich?
American cheese. That's the kind I like best. Sometimes I used to eat two or three a day.
Oh, you're so cute. Oh, I'm awfully sorry.
Oh, my goodness.
You're all wet. Yes. You must take him off.
Oh, I hardly think it's necessary.
Oh, yes, yes.
Well,
what would happen to me if you got your cold? Come on, change it.
Huh?
Well, can I help you?
I'd rather not. I fell in a river once and I didn't take long.
Joe.
Oh.
Where is he?
He's in the...
A magician. I underestimated you.
Sorry to disturb you, champ, but here's a cable from your dad.
Oh.
Nice homey place you got here.
Too bad my mom couldn't have sent me a nice wire like this.
Oh, the phone.
Huh?
I'll get it.
Hello?
Yes, he's here, Mrs. Palooka.
No, not Mrs. Palooka. I'm Whitey, Nobby. Whitey, do you remember? You told me to call you up and...
Yes, ma'am. I found her, Mrs. Palooka.
My mom.
I'll send him right back to the hotel. Yes, ma'am. Don't mention it, Mrs. Palooka.
No, I'm not Mrs. Palooka. Nobby, I'm Whitey. You told me to...
Good night, Mrs. Palooka.
The wagon's gonna get that screwball some of these days.
My hat, I...
Oh, Joe!
You both come with me. I want you to meet her.
No, Joe. Your ma'll want to see you alone. I wouldn't barge in between a mother's love for a son for all the gold in the Arabies.
Well, Joe, must you go?
Of course. It's Mom.
Oh.
Nobby, do me a favor.
What is it?
Will you stay here and keep Miss Madeira company?
Sure, Joe.
Oh, thanks, Nobby. That's awfully nice of you. I'm sorry to jump out like this, but you know how it is with a mother.
What a face. The brow of a genius with sharp, chiseling features. And they talk about Barrymore.
Scram.
Not that. Say it isn't so.
Oh, what are you talking about?
Let's not waste time on subtleties and idle banter. I'm nuts about you, Nina.
You're nuts, all right.
Don't talk like that. I can give you love, money, position, everything.
Oh, let go of me. You're crazy.
I am crazy. Crazy about you. You've got this. You've got that. And boy, you've got those. You're a pip. You've got it. Can't you see you're even making a poet out of me? Me rhyming it with Pip.
Stop it, you're hurting me.
It's only temporary. Each man kills the thing he loves. If I should die tomorrow, I would say this tonight. Take a peek at that profile. Don't that do nothing to you?
Yeah.
That's the ultimate insult.
Nina, open the door.
Does Max what?
My nemesis.
If he finds you here, he wipes off the floor with you. You better hide someplace.
Where?
There.
That's the final degradation.
Oh, go on.
take it down.
Just a minute, darling. I opened the door in a second, sweet. Hello? Hello, operator. Send the house detectives off right away. Hello, darling. What's the matter, sweet? You look mad.
Where is that guy?
What guy?
I saw you leave the club with Palooka.
Why, that's very funny. He hasn't been here. Besides, he don't even know where I live. Now, darling.
Can that stuff. I know you're lying.
All right, if you think I'm lying, why don't you go and look for yourself?
That's just what I'm going to do.
All right, go ahead. Now, darling, aren't you ashamed of yourself? After the way I love you, you don't even trust me. Oh, baby.
What's the trouble, Miss Madeira?
Throw this log out of here.
I'm sorry, Mac, but you'll have to get out.
Don't be so sorry, boys. I'll be glad to go. I'm going to get out. And so will you when I stop paying the rent. So long, two-timer.
You're learning fast, Yoko.
Huh?
What was Mr. McSwat doing here?
Oh, he's just a little jealous because I like you. By the way, how is your mother?
Oh, somebody must have been playing a joke on Nobby. She wasn't there.
Oh.
Where is Nobby?
Here's where she belongs. Oh, you wait here for me, and I go and get my wrap, and we go places, huh?
Oh, it's getting kind of late. I think I...
Not for us, darling angel. Good night, funny man, with a big nose. You do, gentlemen.
Hiya, fellas.
It's about time. I've been waiting here an hour.
Well, we're here, aren't we?
I'm not talking to you. As far as I'm concerned, you can leave right now.
Oh, wait a minute, Nobby. I don't pose for any ads without Nina. She'll add the feminine touch.
She'll add the touch, all right.
Miss Palooka, photographer's waiting.
Go on, Nina.
Wait a minute. It ain't in the contract.
Well, put it in, Nobby, because that's the way it's going to be.
How do you like that?
Will you sign the releases, Mr. Palooka?
Mr. Walsh will attend to that.
Mr. Walsh, please.
I'll sign reluctantly. Come on, Whitey.
How about this?
Why, it's preposterous.
Hold it. That's all, thank you. Will you make your changes, please?
Come on, honey. Everything all right, Nobby?
Let's get out of here before they raid the joint.
Here's the boys, Nobby.
Hello, Nobby. Good afternoon, gentlemen. Listen, you mugs. I'm giving you a chance to make some easy money. Well, here it is. All you gotta do is lay down the first time you get hit. I don't want my boy to hurt his hands. Do you understand? And if any of you guys let Palooka know that these fights ain't on the level, he's gonna feel the wrath of Nobby Walsh. Any wrath feelers in the crowd?
No.
All right, then we proceed. Cardoni, you fight in Pittsburgh on the 15th. O'Shea, have your boy in Buffalo on the 20th. Patrick, I want you to fight in Detroit on the 26th. Will you stop wee-wee and all over the joints? Wee-wee. I give up. Where you going?
Places.
I got an offer for personal appearances in Vaudeville I got to talk to you about.
later.
But this is important.
Gosh, that's gonna look swell on Nina.
Well, if you ain't the sucker.
What do you mean?
That dame ain't in love with you. She's in love with the championship.
What I do outside the ring is none of your business. This is love, Nobby. You wouldn't understand.
I understand, all right. For a dame, you'd bite the hand that yanked you out of the gutter. For a dame, you'd kick a beautiful friendship right in the teeth. You're just putty in a woman's hand. Something to ravish and cast aside.
Ah, monsieur, he's very handsome.
Yeah.
Will you do one thing for me before you go?
What is it?
Kiss me.
Kiss him, Alphonse.
What's the matter?
If I'd have wanted that pressed, I'd have sent it to a tailor.